In the annals of history, few rulers evoke as much horror and condemnation as Leopold II of Belgium. Beneath the facade of a civilized monarch lay the heart of a brutal colonial tyrant, whose reign over the Congo Free State stained the pages of history with blood and suffering. Leopold II ascended to the throne of Belgium in 1865, driven by ambitions of colonial expansion. While other European powers carved up Africa, Leopold saw opportunity in the Congo, a land rich in resources and untouched by European influence. Under the guise of humanitarianism and civilizing missions, Leopold embarked on a campaign of exploitation and cruelty unparalleled in colonial history. The Congo Free State became his personal fiefdom, a private enterprise for his insatiable greed. The atrocities committed under Leopold's rule are staggering. Millions of Congolese men, women, and children were subjected to forced labor, brutal beatings, and mutilations. Villages were razed, families torn apart, all in the pursuit of profit. Resistance was met with ruthless violence. The red rubber system, where Congolese workers were required to meet impossible rubber quotas under threat of amputation or death, became a symbol of Leopold's tyranny. Despite efforts to conceal the truth, reports of the atrocities in the Congo began to surface, sparking international outrage. Activists such as E.D. Morel and Roger Casement exposed the horrors, leading to investigations and diplomatic pressure on Belgium. In 1908, under mounting pressure, Leopold was forced to relinquish control of the Congo Free State to the Belgian government. However, justice for his crimes remained elusive. Leopold died in 1909, escaping the consequences of his actions. Leopold II of Belgium may have passed from this world, but his legacy lives on, a stark reminder of the depths of human cruelty and the price of unchecked power. May we never forget the suffering endured by the Congolese people under his rule.